Hi everyone. I do not have a very I don't have a very fancy financial heavy story. I don't have a very fancy vita or like a very heavy financial bank sheet. But however, I have a cute story to share with you, which I think 95% of you will relate to. I am a diabetic person, which means my pancreas are lazy. Essentially, I come from a family with 80% of people with diabetes, so it was nothing new to me. It wasn't alien to me. The only thing alien to me was that, hey, now you can't have sugar. At the age of 14, I was diagnosed with diabetes when 2 spoons of sugar in a cup of milk, which meant a lot to me and too much to my doctor, was reduced to 0 overnight. You know how I was diagnosed? My Masi had come home, and in a Marwadi house, we exemplify pain. So she came and she started trying, my legs are hurting, my hands are hurting, my feet are paining, check my glucose levels. Instead of checking hers, I checked mine first, and guess what? I was first class diabetic. My glucose levels were 240. And this is 14-year-old Harsh Kedia sitting in the house who loves to eat. I was 105, 5 feet 5. 5 really worked for me. Yeah, you won't believe when you look at me like this today. And that's the day I decided that chalo doctor ke jaake aate hain. So 3 doctor visits and my mother crying for 5 days straight. What have I done to give birth to a child who's now diagnosed with diabetes? I said, you yourself have it. So let's tackle it together. Multiple dietitians, nutritionists, doctors later, I came up with a page called A Diabetic Chef. I was 16 that time, it's been 9 years today. Like I said, there's no fancy story. I started it to share my journey with parents of diabetic kids so they don't have to have the same plight as my mother did. Because trust me, watching a mother or a father crying with a diabetic kid is worse for the child mentally and traumatic. My mother told me to not talk about my diabetes to friends and family and teachers because they said they look at you differently. And the relatives said, who will marry you? The joke's on them, I never want to get married. However, coming to today, talk about the business and the brand. I don't want to talk into what all we do. I'd love for you guys to go on the web and look it up. But what I've been able to do is I have almost 10 lakh people who read my blogs about diabetes. I have 1,000 doctors, 2 lakh Indians who subscribe to my chocolates. They're whatever, they're great, they're healthy, they taste damn good. And I promise you, they're better than most brands. Not just like, it's not a competition. But yes, we believe in what we sell, healthy, sugar-free, diabetes friendly. To validate the last 30 seconds of this conversation, because I was given only 3 minutes, is that 3 big things happened to my life with this journey of Diabetic Chef. I got into college for economics honors, dropped out to become a chef, worked in kitchens and restaurants now for 8 years, made it to Forbes 13 to 30 Asia and India as the youngest ever in the globe to make it to that list as a chef. Third, I'm sharing this stage with some lovely CEOs, CMOs, who make EBITDA of like I don't know how much and how that really works, because I've been in the kitchen for all my life. But all I have to say is be nice to people with diabetes. Thank you.
I have Vikram's question. Turn over.
So we're making 1.75 crores a year. We're a 2-year-old company. Bottom line, we're currently going through like operational losses, let's see. But yeah.
And when you say it's diabetic friendly, can you explain that?
So essentially, diabetes friendly is not just about the sugar. It's also the carbs, it's also the source of fat, the protein that you bring to it. So if you check our website out, our products have contributing factors of the fiber, the protein, and the sources. So we add millets to it, we add berries to it, we add a lot of things. Like it was very rightly mentioned, a lot of sugar-free chocolates have palm oil in it. So palm oil never gets digested in your system. So we get the best quality cocoa beans, get the butter out, make excellent chocolates that actually are healthy for you. It does not spike your glucose levels. How I can say that is, all our chocolates are given to patients with CGMs, those ultra-cyborg patches that people wear these days in college, very savvy. So our chocolates are given to them, their glucose levels are tested, and then they're deemed.
So you don't get a spike in this?
No, the 5 to 7 mgdl on a 10 gram chocolate is absolutely normal. It's like having water and going for a walk.
Thank you.
I get the impact for diabetics. Why chocolates?
As a boy of 15 sitting in class on my birthday, I couldn't give chocolates out. Because the teacher said, oh, this boy has diabetes, I don't think we should give chocolates out in class, where all the other boys are allowed to distribute chocolates. So I said, I'm going to make something for kids who can have it themselves. Also, as a travel snack, when we're going in trains and as a family when we used to go out, we used to have thepla, achar, bhujia and mithai. I couldn't have achar, bhujia and mithai, so I thought I'll start with one part of it, which is chocolates. And you can't carry cake everywhere like I used to, so I make those bars in flavors of desserts. Thanks a lot, everyone.